then, little Miss Foster. Make me proud.
Right, Hugh, I saw the film this morning and I really, really loved it.
No, good.
You said it kind of brought you out of semi-retirement, I guess.
Yes.
What about this film made you just say yes?
Well, it wasn't difficult. I mean, look, it was a really interesting, strange, nuanced part, and a sort of thing that people don't normally offer me. And classy, you know, Meryl Streep, Stephen Frears, good script, strange tone that was half comedic, half sort of moving and sad. So I really felt I had to do it.
Cosme McMoon.
That's me, sir.
So, Simon, how was it to get out of the Howard Wolowitz dickie and into a bow tie?
I never did. I wore it the whole shoot. It was too tight. They just cut me out eventually.
And how was it on that first day when you walked on set and you were like, oh my God, there's Meryl Streep and there's Hugh Grant?
Yeah, well, it wasn't quite as abrupt as that. Like, it was a slow burn. When we started shooting, it was sort of shocking. I forgot about the acting and it was all music for a while. And then you realize, oh my God, I'm in this movie. I am, oh my God. And Hugh's sort of that way. Oh my God. And Meryl too. I think we all, you know, but I think it worked, you know, we tried to, I think you bring what you have. And luckily my character is constantly sweating and looking around like he's just a fish out of water. So I think I had a little bit of that naturally.
This is what we live for, isn't it? This moment.
I loved it so much. And it was good, such a good role for you as well.
Thanks.
And you look very sharp in it. Is there something about period clothes that helps you get into a character a bit
yeah,
more?
It really did help, actually. I was watching at the premiere yesterday. Certain costumes got me better into character than others. That black, the blue suit, I'm perfectly in character. When I'm wearing the tweed jacket, I thought, not so much.
So this film is kind of about passion and
yeah.
Meryl's character, Florence, does something that she kind of doesn't think or doesn't notice the critics.
Yeah.
Have you ever been so passionate about something that you just thought, like, screw it, I'm just going to do
no,
it?
No, I'm way too insecure. I think most people are.
Well, I suppose the campaign I've been doing for the last 5 years, which is in a way PR suicide, I suppose I must have thought, screw it, because you couldn't get worse feedback than by taking on Britain's tabloid press.
Another take?
Well, I don't see why. That seemed perfect to me.
How was it working with Meryl? She seems like so much fun. What's she like when the cameras aren't rolling?
Well, if it's not a filming day, she's a lovely person, very interesting and amusing. If it's a filming day, she tends to be in the mood that is required for the scene. So if it's a happy party scene, she'll be jovial. But if it's a very sad scene, a very sad Meryl appears on the set.
And what are you going to do? Are you still going to kind of be in semi-retirement, or do you think this is going to be...
Yeah. I still have work to do with the politics, and I'm quite happy doing it. But, you know, if someone dangles something intriguing from the world of show business in front of me, it's quite nice to do it now. It feels like a holiday.
And all the reviews are just terrific.
Yeah.
Ours is a very happy world.